my sand legs back. Oh, this is pretty packed down. It's definitely still loose. Oh, gotta put my foot down. For those of you not familiar with riding in the Southwest, a lot of the roads go through areas that are called washes, dry washes. And basically you're riding through what's basically a river with no water in it. So you're riding on some pretty deep sand. There's an old mine site over this way I'm gonna go check out. Last time I was here, there wasn't too much left. There's our secret trail over there. I'm gonna head up here. Take a minute. Once again, in front of us, that's Vulture Peak out there. Taller handlebars would definitely be pretty nice. For as much as you have to get up on the bars, at least in this terrain, you're not going to spend your time sitting on the plank. so I'm leaning over at about a 60 degree angle or so, I guess. Oops, missed my turn. Truman, that's what it was. I'm trying to think of, there's an old miner out here and I accidentally crossed his quote unquote territory and was driving the Rhino. He boxed me in and definitely made me a little bit nervous, but I always come prepared. But he ended up turning out to be a pretty decent guy. I don't know if he's still out here or not. But these guys get awful protective out here. These miners get awful protective about their sites, even though it's all Bureau of Land Management. Woo! Let's not get overly confident on our first ride out. Anywho, he boxed me in and put his hand on my Rhino and told me I couldn't come through there anymore, and I asked him why not. And we came to a mutual agreement and shook hands, and that was a couple of years ago, but he did invite me to come by. As long as I was in his mind sight, because he was concerned about others following me. It took him about 10 minutes to see all my cameras, and then he got nervous. There it is. There's old Truman's site over there. Most of what goes on out here is not your, you know, what you think about mining. Hard rock mining enough. Inside of a underground mine. It's what's called placer mining. And you see it on most of the mining shows on TV, like Gold Rush and that kind of stuff. There's a couple others. And basically you're digging up the soil and betting that you find enough gold per ton to make it worth your while digging it out. And obviously the key is to make it less money per ton to dig it out than it is to sell your gold. Most people I've talked to, it's more of a hobby than a way it means of making a living. Well, there sure is a lot of sand here. where I'm at here.
Well, so far we're about, I don't know, about 8 miles into the ride, and it's going pretty good. Only had one little get off a little bit there, and my mistake, my fault. It's been quite some time since I've been on a little dirt bike, so I'm getting my ergonomics and weight transfer and all that stuff together. Is definitely a little bit of a curve, especially in the sand. I think a better set of tires will do that fine, but I'm going to wait till these things are slicks before I do that. 13 tooth sprocket, I think that can probably happen. I mean, for the $15, it's probably worth the investment. As far as an aftermarket exhaust and chip and all that stuff, that the Stage 1 kit that everybody talks about, I'm not certain that at this point it's really required. I mean, if you're looking for just a trail bike, I think it does pretty good. My anticipation of it is probably different, or my expectation of it is probably different than everybody else's, but I'm not looking for a motocross bike. When I bought it, I didn't expect it to be a motocross bike. I was looking at, you know, the KLX 250. WR is a nice bike, but it was way out of my price range, so I didn't even consider that. So I'm thinking that this is KLX 250 at least. It was cheaper and it's got injection in it and stuff like that. Handles really well. It's a nice light bike. A lot of the quote-unquote problems that everybody talks about, it depends on, you know, if you're expecting a motocross bike. If you want a motocross bike or a super trail bike, then you're probably looking at a CFR or CRF 250X. You know, you want a completely different bike. No qualms about it. This is a dual sport, not unlike what the KLR is versus, you know, WR 450 or CRF 450. There's a night and day difference between them, and it's your expectations. I'm not going to hammer through trails. I'm not going to do motocross. I'm not going to jump with it. At least that's what I told my wife. So I'm going to do a little bit more riding and get some more impressions here.